वंदे गुरुपद्द्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमित श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नितानंदसहोदित श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समयुक्त बिंदावनम मनो वांछाकल्पतरुश्च कृपा सिंधु वच पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्किपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवम् वृंदावै तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशवश्च कृष्णभक्तिपदे देवी सत्त्वतत्त्वै नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीर संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरी अपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नमभीष्टदोहम् तेथास्पदम् शिव विरिञ्चनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतातिहम् पनतपाल भवद्विभूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पादपल्लवनकचन्दमनि छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गभवधुस्वदर्श पूर्णानुरागर स्वसागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौर भक्तबिंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौर भक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदातु संकेतनैकपितरु कमलायताक्षु भीषाम्बरु द्विजवरौ जुगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत प्रिय करु करुणावतारु हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगा तरंग रमणीय जटा कलापम गौरी निरंतर विभूषी त्वाम भागम नारायणो प्रियमनंग मदापहारम वाराणसीपुरपति भजबीशनाथम वागीश जुष्यो वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति देशम्भिः त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Labdha sudurlabhamidam bahusham bhavante manasamarthadamanittamapi hadhiraha turnam jateta na pateta anumetu yavat nistriyasayo visayoho khalu sarvatoho svat labdha sudurlabhamidam bahusham bhavante manasamarthadamanittamapi hadhiraha turnam jateta na pateta anumetu yavat Nisriyo sayo visayo kalu sarvatoho svat. Gauriya Goshtipati, Jagadguru Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that we are here in this material world only for 2 days. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, we are here in this material world only for 2 days. There is no surety when we can go away from this material world. There is no surety, no guarantee. We have no pre-notice, we have no notice that when we can go away from this material world. So while living in this material world, we must take a final decision to do Hari Bhajan. This is a must. Because for infinity period we are traveling all around these 14 worlds. And by chance we have this human body, Prabhupada speaking. This human body is just fit for Hari Bhajan. This human body is just fit for Hari Bhajan. So we must take final decision to settle down. We must settle down our mind to do actual Hari Bhajan. Those who are going to jump into fire, we cannot say they are, those who are going to jump into Maya, they are with enjoying mood, we cannot say actually they are actually intelligent. Jehi sansparsaja bhogaha dukshajane evate adyantabantukantiyo nateshu ramate buddhaha. Those who are really intelligent, they never go for sensual gratification, sensual enjoyment. They are less interested about that. Because Prabhupada speaking, that matter, any inert object, cannot have any enjoying mood. Any inert object cannot have any enjoying mood. It is impossible. Your body is also inert, but Atma is there, soul is there. That's why you are interested to enjoy. So, labdha sudura labhamidam bahusam bhavante, after long, long time, now, today, we have the chance to take this human body. This manusya marthada manittam api yadhiraha. Manusya marthada, marthada mean which can give actual meaning. Actual meaning of this life. Marthada, marthada mean it can give artho. Artho mean, marthada is an actual meaning. No, dharma artha kam mokha, this artha, I am not speaking about this artha. This artha mean, we after putting energy, Baddha jeev want to get something in return, remuneration, to ensure his enjoying life. I am not speaking about this artha. Dharma artha kam mokha, this artha na. Actually, here, this artha means, actually, it is meaningful. Meaningful means, there is every possibility that you can start Hari Bhajan. Not only that, but also you can get the darshan of Supreme Lord, you can enter into eternal world. You can get eternal seva, nitya seva. So, manushya marthada manitya mapiyo adhiraha anitya, unstable, but still has some meaning of this life. Because you can remember Khattanga Raja, those demigods, they are going to give some blessing to him. We like to give something. Which you want? What you want? Khattangara speaking, I like to know in details about my lifespan, how long I am going to live. Oh my God, you are going to live only, you know, very small. 48 minutes. Dudondo. Within that period, Khattanga Raja threw everything and took decision to start Hari Bhajan. He came out successful. Parikshit Maharaj took decision very quickly, and within 7 days, you know everything. So I'm not going into details. So though it's unstable, but still it can give you real meaning of this life. So those who are dhiraha, those who are going to settle down their mind, very peaceful, there are no agitation, no anxiety, nothing, they are going to take decision that before leaving this body, turnam jatet na patet anumuttu javat, so long as I am going to live, then I will have to take it. Nisriya sayaha visayaho khalu sarvataho sat. Matter you can get everywhere. In any birth, bees, insect, spider, you know, honeybees, beast and birds, any life, enjoyment is there. Enjoyment is always there in different way. So actually, nisriya sayo visaha visayaho khalu sarvato sat, everywhere, in every life, you can get enjoyment. You can arrange, you can try to get enjoyment, and you will have to also suffer, because according to your previous karma fall, you will have to suffer, or you can get some enjoyment. That is unstable, you see. So, Prahlad Maharaj actually is saying that in any life you can get enjoyment, so you should not be busy with this, you know, matter of enjoyment. So you will have to think over and again about how to do Hari Bhajan. That is the main problem. And actually, Nisriyasaya, Prabhupada explaining this word. Prabhupada explained Nisriyasaya. What do you mean Nisriyas? Sreyo and Peyo. Prabhupada often used to speak these two words. Sreyo and Peyo. Sreyo mean actually the highest, actually ultimate good. And Peyo mean actually what your sense organ want to, what your material mind want to enjoy. That is Preyo, actually. The Prabhupada want to explain that Nisriyasaya, this word, Nisriyaso, Prabhupada speaking, the meaning of this word is to get Bhagavad Anugraha, Bhagavad Kipa. Prabhupada speaking, the meaning of this word Nisriyo is to get Bhagavad Anugraha or Bhagavad Kipa. But surely we are not going to get Bhagavad Kipa directly through Sadhu Guru Vishnam. That's mean to get Kipa from a pure Sadhu Guru Vishnam, Bhagavad Kipa, it is called Nisriyasa. Nisriyasa means it can give our ultimate good. So actually, Kuloseka, actually you can remember, is crying. We are less interested about Hari Bhajan. But Kulasekhar crying all day and night, Prabhu, I like to reach your lotus feet. I don't like to stay here. I can discuss this point. Before that, I like to give you one reminder from Brihad Bhagavatamrita, Brihad Aranyaka Upanishad. Brihad Aranyaka Upanishad, there you can find that Jagavalka Rishi is speaking in front of Gargi. Gargi Maitri, two wives actually. Now Gargi putting question in front of you know Jagavalka Rishi. Jo, actually you are going to distribute all your property among we two wives. But I like to put question in front of you. With the help of this property, I can get that absolute truth. Is it possible? Gargi putting this question in front of Jagavalka. Jagavalka cannot give answer. After some time, going to answer that no. By the help of this property, you cannot get that absolute truth. Then why you are going to distribute this property among us, which is useless? Which is useless, you are going to distribute among us. What we can, by the help of which we cannot get that absolute truth. Why you are going to give this property to us? Tenaham kum kim kuryam, jenaham no, Jenaham na amritam asnute, by the help of which I am not going to get that nectar. Nectar mean bhakti. Nectar mean bhakti actually. In 10th canto already many times I told before, Bhagavan Sri Krishna explaining in front of Gopikas, that mai bhaktir hi bhutanam amritutaya kalpate. Those demigods, they are going to get nectar by churning of sea, ocean, samudra manthan. But that nectar is not going to give this result. That is not actually nectar. You can get some bodily facility, some mundane material facility you can get. There can be no disease, no sweat, no tiredness, nothing. You can enjoy your life. So those demigods, they are enjoying their life because they are already have this nectar. So I am not going to speak about the nectar. So Gargi is speaking, Gargi Maitri, he is Samin. By the help of which we are not going to get that nectar, Amrit. What we can do with this property? Then after that, Jagavalka Rishi speaking, etat aksharam gargi viditva asmat lokat paiti sa brahmana. Who is Brahman? Who is not Brahman? This question, Prabhupada very often used to point out this point, this thing. Jagavalka speaking, etad aksharam gargi viditva asmat lokat paiti sa brahmana. After knowing that absolute Brahma, absolute tattva, etad aksharam, om iti eka aksharam, Brahma, jab baharan mamansparan, this sloka in Gita, this you can remember, this is actually Parabrahma. So if you can understand the total exact meaning of this Om, this Akshar, if you can understand in details by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, then everything clear to you. So who is Brahman? etad aksharam gargi viditva. Viditva, viditva mean after knowing this akshar, Brahma. If somebody is going to leave this world, he is actually Brahman. Poiti sa Brahman. Etad aksharam gargi aviditva asmat lokat poiti sa kripanaha. He is kripan. He is a fallen soul who is not having any information about this khar ebang akshar. Very often Prabhupada used to explain khar ebang akshar. Khar means is a, you know, changeable, you know, unstable. Everything what is visible in front of you, all unstable, and it's khar. Akshar means never changeable. In infinity period of time, there is no question of changing. So, who is Brahman? Prabhupada speaking, that material mind, what do you mean by material mind? What do you mean by material mind? Because Atma, spirit, your Atma have no relation with that material body and mind. Your Atma having no relation with your material body and material mind. But still, there is one bridging, there is one connection because of Maya. With the mood, with the feeling, your Atma, bonded soul, when want to enjoy, this mood of enjoyment is expressed as material mind. Actually, there is no existence of material mind. Because you are already told many times, it is, you know, that bhumi, rapo, anolo, vayu, khang, mana, buddhi, revacha, ahankara, ityamme, prakriti, rastada. All the eight different kind of manifestation or expression of this maya. You have no connection with that. Matter means matter. Matter can come in different way. I already told. This Prakriti Devi nature, this material nature, is opening one big market of enjoyment. This Prakriti Devi, this nature, this Prakriti Devi going, Prakriti Devi opening one big market of enjoyment. And according to your previous sanskar demand, you are going to market to select your item of enjoyment. This is one. You are going to select your part. Prakriti can take 100%. Prakriti can take revenge against you. If you are going to express your enjoying mood, be sure. Prakriti Devi is going to take revenge against you. Because Prakriti Devi speaking that all the items I here exhibit here. I open a big market of, you know, sabda, sparsa, rupa, rasa, gandha. You know, sabda, sparsa, rupa, rasa, gandha. I open big market enjoyment. But that enjoyment is for Supreme Lord, not for you. So you bonded soul, directly or indirectly, you will have to always maintain accuracy of your mind. You should think those things which you can see all around you is not an object of your enjoyment, is all directly or indirectly, all are the items of Krishna Seva. All are the items of Krishna Seva. You have no doubt, only you can take prasadam. This is the mood of Siddha Mahatma. So, very often Prabhupada used to speak that bonded soul always try to express enjoying mood. But Prabhupada speaking that actually if you cannot feel that the whole world actually everything is unstable. if still today you are going to get some enjoyment, if still today you are going to get some enjoyment from this material world, if still today if you are going to get some enjoyment from this material world, be sure it is not possible for you to do Hari Bhajan. Prabhupada speaking, actually in preliminary stage, maybe you can have some enjoying mood, but through your submission, through your Guru Vaishnav Seva, gradually you can go up to that level of full surrender. Ultimately you can go, but if there is a duplicity, then you cannot get free of this material clutcher. Shobhari Rishi, actually after that Ajamil, after that, you know what, forget that, you know, Jodu is son, actually, I forget the name. Prabhupada speaking, ultimately, through their enjoyment, they are ultimately going to develop detachment, because they are simple at heart. There is no complicacy. Jajati, Shauhari, there is no complicacy inside their heart. That's why you can find their enjoying mood. They have Maharaj, they have enjoying mood. Yes, they have enjoying mood. They are also speaking, we have enjoying mood, is very, very bad. They are always going to decry. They are going to decry their enjoying mood. What to do? Then somehow they are leading their life, but ultimately they want to cut their bondage. They have their honesty. They have their honest desire. They have their honest desire inside their heart that we like to cut material. But what to do now in bonded condition? Prabhupada speaking, those who are having this kind of, you know, simple mood, no complicacy. In that case, though at present you can find they are having some enjoying mood, but gradually they can develop detachment by the mercy of Guru Vishnu. Provided they have no complicacy inside their heart. So there was no complicacy inside the heart of Sauvaridisi, Jajati, you know, Ajami, no complicacy. That's why ultimately, so many times I told before from Bhagavatam, Akama Sarvakama Va Mokshakama Udaradhi Tivrena Bhakti Yogena Jajeta Purusham Param. This is true. Akama Sarvakama, just now I explained, though you have enjoying mood, but still, if you are going to decry, you know, very bad. I have enjoying mood. I cannot get control over my mind and sense organ. This is why if you are going to decry enjoying mood, then you can get some help. So automatically you are going to cut material bondage, and ultimately you can, and now start eternal seva. That you can do in Siddha Avastha. But not before. So Prabhupada speaking, material mind, what is material mind? Actual material mind is, Prabhupada explaining, that your enjoying mood, your enjoyment, but the bonded soul when expressing enjoying mood, this enjoying mood in the form of material mind expressing, are going to accept matters relating to his enjoyment, or going to reject which not going to accept. This way, rejection and acceptance going on. Sometime accepting, sometime rejecting, according to his previous sanskar. But actually, Prabhupada speaking, it was the mood of Prabhupada that always you go on doing Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan Seva. Prabhupada speaking, that those who are going to do continuous Guru Vaishnava Bhagavat Seva, their material bondage cannot stand for a long time. Prabhupada speaking, if they are going to do Seva continuously, Guru Vaishnava Bhagavat Seva, Prabhupada is speaking in Bengali, Jara Guru Vaishnava Bhagavaner Nirantar Seva Vyasto, Tara they can get rid of this material bondage. Maya cannot get any scope, any space to get entry. They can get rid of Maya very shortly. But actually, Prabhupada speaking, bonded soul, they are acting like a hero, heroine or villain in a drama. Prabhupada speaking, that those who are going to play in drama, there is no reality. There is actually no reality, but those who are audience, they are going to feel it is reality. So Prabhupada speaking, this has become a chronic disease for us to do some drama in the form of sannyasi, in the form of brahmachari, in the form of grihastha, perfect ideal grihastha. But ideal grihastha, you know, Prabhupada speaking, ideal grihastha, we cannot imagine even. If you can see the life of an ideal grihastha, they are havoc responsibility, big responsibility. Prabhupada speaking, if one ideal grihastha, if you can see, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Sivas Pandit, Bhakeshwar Pandit, Sivananda Sen, not Bhakeshwar Pandit, Sivananda Sen, you can see their life, ideal. And Mahaprabhu himself also. So ideal grihastha, their responsibility is so high, and their, procedure or bhajan so excellent that we cannot imagine. That bonded, actually those who are ideal grihastha, they have so many responsibilities, they have so much burden on their head, but still they are going to do bhajan and they are going to discharge their duty, okay, but all in relation to Supreme Lord. They are going to discharge their duty one by one. But you will have to think, twice, that what kind of responsibility grihastha man have. Big responsibility. And if they are not going to get control over their sense organ, what responsibility they can take? A grihastha going to discharge a big duty. And all Sadhu Guru Vaishnav, they are going to depend upon them. I depend upon Krishna, but still externally, they are going to do something, and also daily, seva, they are doing everything. So actually, if they are out of controlling of their sense organ, what responsibility we can expect they can take? What kind of big responsibility they can take? So ideal grihastha is much more than ordinary devotees, those who are in renounced order. Much more, big responsibility. They have big responsibility. Of course, a genuine Gauriya sadhu, sannyasi, brahmachari or acharya, they have big responsibility. They are going to take the responsibility of whole, human society. If they are going to take care of their fooding and lodging, only they are busy with their fooding and lodging, what they can, enjoy. This is not actually tyagi. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that this kind of tyagi is useless. This kind of tyagi, if the number of this kind of tyagi increasing, then it must be a plotting of maya. It's very, So, Prabhupada speaking, that just like in a drama, if we find somebody is acting, there is no reality. Those who are going to take sannyas, brahmacharya, vesa, everything, but if there is no reality, then what use? It is just like drama. So it is more and more dangerous. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is more and more dangerous. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, so long as they are not going to grow their detachment, they should not come out of family life. It is good. They should stay in family life. They can try to prove that we are grihastha, we are fallen soul. This kind of humble mood can develop inside their heart. This is very good. So, but it is not good that they can take sannyas and brahmacharya base and red clothes, everything, and they can do, make a drama in front. And this whole society is very, they are foolish, number one. They also cannot understand what is false, what is good, what is genuine. They can, because they themselves, they are cheater. They are actually foolish. They have no sincerity. They don't like to get their absolute truth. That's why they are also, you know, going to be cheated by them. And also Baba speaking like a genuine gold. Genuine gold and, you know, imitation gold. There, what kind of difference? There is a havoc difference. So, genuine tyagi, those who are actually developing, you know, detachment, is rare at present. So, Prabhupada speaking, actually, first of all, we should go on hearing Harikatha, repeatedly Prabhupada speaking. This is the topmost medicine. Continuously we will have to use this medicine of hearing Harikatha and Kirtan, through which gradually we can go out of Maya. That is the procedure. And actually, Kulasekhar speaking something I can discuss, but still today, if I am going to get some enjoyment in this material life, if still today I am going to enjoy something in this material life from this material world, then there is no possibility that I can do actual bhajan. Of course, if there is no duplicity, if there is duplicity, then problem. Now, actually, I can give one example that in Varanasi, Benaras Hindu University, there was one professor of Vedanta. He is a great scholar. Everybody speaking is great Pandit of Vedanta. So, he is daily in the noontime, in a tiffin time, is coming to his home to take food, everything, and after that going back to, again in service, to join service. So he is coming, and that day he is taking chapati and sabji, everything, but by chance, wife forget to give salt in this sabji. But that, you know, that scholar of Vedanta is, you know, is in each and every step is very angry. He is speaking, you are cooking this sabji this way. I am not going to get any nothing, no salt, nothing, no taste there. Repeatedly speaking this thing. Whereas wife in a very appealing mood speaking, what to do? Today I forget, excuse me. I am going to give you salt separately, you can mix. If I add separately, how I can get taste? This way, repeatedly speaking, criticizing. After that, wife was bound to speak this way, that you are the great scholar of Vedanta, I heard. If you are going to expect taste from this material world, you are not going to get any test from Brahma. You are supposed to get test from Brahma. Those who are going to get test in Brahma, how it is possible for them to find test in sabji? Then he gone mad. That was a turning point of his life. Wife was not so educated, but the remark was so, you know, heavy. That he was very honorable person. So that great scholar, he gone mad. He started thinking, really so? I am reading Vedanta, I am, you know, teaching Vedanta, I am explaining, everybody is speaking, I am a great scholar, but I have no direct realization. Regarding direct realization, I can speak another example from Benaras, same place. There was a big Dharma Sabha on Vedanta. Big scholar coming. They are one by one going to pass their remark about Vedanta Sutra, Vedanta as a whole. And, you know, this Vedanta, I mean, Sabha, actually big Dharma Sabha. After the after that, actually, when Sova is going on, big scholar, they are, you know, giving their lecture, Bhasan, on this Vedanta, Sutra, Vedanta Tattva. But after that, when everything, you know, going to complete their speech, almost going to be completed, then that the Maharaj who is presiding over that Sava, requesting one very humble sadhu, Maharaj, you must speak something. He is feeling shy. I cannot speak anything because I am actually illiterate. I have no education. How I can speak? No, you must speak something actually. You must speak something actually for 10 minutes, 15 minutes. You must. He is speaking, I am actually not Pandit of Vedanta, but requesting repeatedly. Then he started speaking on Vedanta. When he started speaking on Vedanta after Bandana, all Pandit there, they gone mad. They all gone mad. How it is possible he is speaking that I am actually not Pandit of Vedanta, I know nothing, I am not educated, but he is explaining Vedanta in such a way. They gone mad. After the Sava is over, all Pandit they are requesting that, you know, Maharaj, that how you develop this kind of accuracy and a feeling, how you develop this kind of, you know, sensitivity, how you explain this kind of Vedanta, what is the procedure? But whereas we are not successful, then that Maharaj speaking, I used to love my Guru Maharaj. My Guru Maharaj used to love me from heart. I used to do my seva. My Guru Maharaj gone. Before going, he blessed me. He was bound to bless me. And by his blessing, I realized something, nothing else. Now they are putting, how it is possible for you, this question. Whereas we have no direct realization how. Then that Maharaj speaking, that you started reading Vedanta with what objective, with what idea, what, you know, was your plan? Before you take admission in Vedanta, what was your plan? Then that great scholar, some they are speaking, we wanted to become a great scholar of Vedanta. Then Maharaj speaking, so you are. You wanted to become a great scholar of Vedanta, so you are. You never wanted to pray unto the lotus feet of Vedanta to get realization. Whereas I always praying unto the lotus feet of Vedanta, I am fallen soul, I am foolish number one, I am illiterate, please do some kippa, express some kippa on me. This way actually, direct realization. You can go through so many sastra, so many countless sastra. You can memorize, you can earn the name of big Pandit, Digvijay Pandit even. But you cannot get direct realization without Guru Kipa. Without Guru Kipa, it is impossible to digest all sastra. Any sastra you can memorize, maybe you have memory power is very high, but you cannot digest. Because by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, you can digest. You can digest this kippa. Press always and every time Prabhupada wanted to speak this way. Prabhupada always wanted to speak. We, Prabhupada speaking, that we always want to project ourselves as a big preacher, big acharya, big scholar. This is our mood. But we are less interested about getting realization. Prabhupada speaking, that we are always interested to get some, you know, some knowledge, everything, external knowledge, everything, dry knowledge. So we want to always express ourselves, project ourselves as a big acharya, big sannyas, big pandit. We want to express ourselves. But that was not the mood of Prabhupada. Prabhupada always want to see. You want to project yourself as a great big pacharak, big preacher. But this is not the rule. You should not express that kind of mood. Otherwise, you cannot. If you express this kind of mood, you cannot get bhakti. Because regarding bhakti, I already told before that somebody going to show that I have detachment, those mayavadis, they have more and more detachment, external detachment, but useless. Those mayavadis, they are going to show more and more detachment, but what use of that detachment? That detachment, dry detachment. So, those who are devotee, they are always busy with Yukta Vairagya. Each and every time Prabhupada used to speak this point, and we always want to express that I have detachment, I have scholarship, I have this, that, but that is not the procedure. That is not the procedure, Prabhupada's song. So, bhakti parishanubhav, viraktir annatra choisho tik ek kalaha, prapadya manasya yathasnataha, su tushti pushti khut payonughasam. Bhakti parishanubhav, viraktir annatra, all simultaneously you can get. Bhakti, when you are going to get bhakti, at the same time, bhakti, after that, parishanubhav, at the same time. Parishanubhav, paro isho unubhav, direct feeling about that Supreme Lord, about your seva, about Guru Vaishnava. So when you are going to get bhakti, be sure with that bhakti, parishanubhav, mane paro isho unubhav, direct realization, you can, surely you can get, and virakti ranatra mane, you are going to feel, grow detachment for matters, those who have no relationship with Krishna Bhajan. Krishna Sevai Jaha Hai Anukul Vishaya Boliya Taha Tagi Hai Bhul. What you can use in Krishna Seva, what you can use in Krishna Seva, if you are going to throw, though I don't need, it is called Dry Vairagya. It is called Dry Vairagya. So, Prabhupada speaking, Krishna Sevai Jaha Hai Anukul Vishaya Boliya Taha Tagi Hai Bhul. You are going to make mistake because this, you know, things you can use in Krishna Seva. Don't try to use it in your own purpose or your own purpose. You can use it for Krishna Seva. So it's called Yukta Vairagya. So it's an automatic factor. Bhakti, Parishanubhav, Virakti Ranatra, Choishatrik Ek Kalaha, Prapadya Manasya. Those was already having submission unto the lotus feet of Sadguru. Prapadya Manasya, be careful. Prapadya Manasya means those who are already having submission unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vishnu, Gurudev, for them. Otherwise, no question. So, Prapadya Manasya, those who are actually full submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Vishnu, you know. Now, one example given here, just one man is very, very hungry for some days, he is not going to take anything. For a few days, he is not going to take anything. Very hungry, very hungry. The example giving here, yatha asnataha, when he is going to take prasadam one by one, one handful of prasadam, second handful of prasadam. Vishwanatha Chakravarti speaking, with each and every handful of prasadam, when going to put into mouth, then he is going to get some satisfaction, and satisfaction means tushti, and pushti means nourishment, and khut payo, and he is hungry, and you know, he is feeling hungry, but now actually, gradually it is going on, because he is taking prasadam. So simultaneously, when he is going to take prasadam, he is getting satisfaction, Jatha asnataha, when going to take prasadam, simultaneously going to get satisfaction and nourishment, and is going to, you know, and going to feel that he is not hungry. These three things are at a time can get this kind of. So this kind of, you know, this kind of example given by Prabhupada, ye bhakti hi parishanubhavo virakti ranatraha, Choisha triko ek kalaha, prapadya manasya yathasnataha, su tushti pushtihi, khut payo anughasam. Anughasam and each and every, handful of prasadam going to give this kind of facilities to you. So each and every step you can get. But our main disease is that, I told you many times before, that Prabhupada never used to give any chance to anybody to take rest. All the time, it was the technique of Prabhupada. Prabhupada always used to engage them in Hari Guru Vaishnava Seva. All the time. Anybody coming to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu after Seva is done, Prabhupada speaking, what Seva at present? What Seva? Then immediately, after one day, Prabhupada giving this, go, do this Seva. Continuous Seva. So all the time, Prabhupada giving Seva to everybody, this is called actually secrecy of bhajan. This way, Prabhupada used to give treatment to all devotees. One day, two or three devotees coming to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, usually Prabhupada used to engage them in Seva. Whenever they are coming, maybe one day, 2 days, maximum after that. The one Maharaj is thinking that I am a great preacher. One Maharaj is thinking I am a great preacher, big Pracharak. He is going to pass one remark about one devotee who is not going for preaching outside. Only busy with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Seva all the time. Busy in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Seva all the time. Someday he is going to pass remark about the devotee. Come on, he is educated. He is not going for preaching, nothing, only staying inside, temple, this, that, passing this kind of bad remarks. This kind of bad remarks. Without any reason. Whereas he is busy in, Seva, given by Prabhupada all the time. Then Prabhupada came to know that he is going to criticize about that devotee. Prabhupada was expressing his mood like lion. Like lion, Prabhupada shouting, who are you to pass this kind of remark about you? Because Sadguru can realize the heart of all sevak. Sadguru can realize the heart of all, disciples. That is why he is Sadguru. He can realize the heart of all, devotees. What kind of mood is there inside them? So Prabhupada, it was known to Prabhupada that that sevak who is doing seva inside Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his mood is always, always resting with Prabhupada. Always unto a lotus feet of Prabhupada. His heart is always resting unto a lotus feet of Prabhupada. So Prabhupada knows it very well, how much love he has for me. So this way Prabhupada used to give treatment, but we want to project ourselves as a big Pracharak, big Acharya, big Sannyas. This way all the time it is our mood. Prabhupada always used to decry this kind of mood. One example I can give, it was from MP, Madhya Pradesh, one place. There was one big Pandit. The Greek Pandit, he took all his education from Banarasi here, the big Pandit. But actually, is very poor. He cannot earn money because he is big Pandit, but not going outside for preaching anyway, is very poor. Somehow he is approaching the king. There was one king, of that, locality, this place, kingdom. And he approaching the king, and the king having some nice relation with him. That Pandit approaching the king and speaking, I like to explain Bhagavatam in front of you. The king is having some spiritual knowledge, actually. He's not in a spiritual personality. That he has a spiritual personality, not actually material man. That king going to request that Pandit, actually still today, you are not going to enjoy the full kippa of Bhagavatam. You are not enjoying the full kippa of Bhagavatam. So how you can explain in front of me? He's saying, why? I got my education from Varanasi. Here they are all big. I can recite all Bhagavatam, everything. Vedanta also, everything. I have degree. But well, you have degree, but you are not enjoying the full kippa of Bhagavatam. So first of you try to get kippa of Bhagavatam, then you can come to me. Go to your guru. Then he was very sad. He gone back. Again after some months, he came back and requesting the king to hear Bhagavatam. Now you can hear Bhagavatam from me. Then king also speaking, that king also, king speaking, that you can go back again and try to get full kippa Bhagavatam, then you can come to me. Again speaking. So 2-3 times he is speaking. It was very derogatory from him. He was feeling insulting from him. He thought, well, I cannot stay. After that, he coming to home, after he feel some detachment, he grow some detachment, he gone to Varanasi and he started reciting Bhagavatam in front of Vishwanath, Kasi Vishwanath at the bank of Ganga. Yes, no more years, he is not coming in front of king to request. The only reason he is coming to king, because he knew it very well, if I am going to recite Bhagavatam, he can give me big donation. That's why he is requesting king, you can hear Bhagavatam. But now, if he grows some detachment, he gone to Varanasi, at the bank of Ganga, in front of Vishwanath, he is reciting Bhagavatam. And someday he feel. Now king searching, where that Pandit gone? 1 year gone, is not coming to me. After that king's, searching, where he gone? He took information here and there. After that, he got information that he already in Varanasi. Then the king in ordinary dress, leaving everything, gone to that spot in Varanasi and praying prostrated dandavat to that Pandit. And king can discover that now he is reciting Bhagavatam with tears rolling down his cheeks. He is not speaking with anybody. Now king going to request him, today I have the scope to hear Bhagavatam from you. Because today you have full kripa of Srimad Bhagavatam. So, if we are not going to Bhakta Bhagavata Grajo na buddhyana chatikaya. If I go through commentary and if I can explain very nicely, that doesn't mean I have direct realization. That doesn't mean I have direct realization. That is, direct realization is a must. South Indian king his name is I already told, Kulasekhar in Mukundamala Sottam writing. What is the mood? Kulasekhar speaking crying in front of Supreme Lord and speaking that Majjanmana Phalamidam Madhukoita Bhare Matpartha Niyo Madanagraha Esha Eva Tadvritta Bhitta Paricharako Bhitta 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 Savhitta Iti Mans Maru Lokonatha. He Loknath, he is speaking, the Kulasekhar. He was a big king, great king in South India, having bhakti in South India. So he is praying unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, O Prabhu. Majjanmana phalamidam madhukoita bhare matparthaniya madanagraha esha eva tadvritta vritta paricharako vritta 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 savitta iti mangs maro lokanatha. He Loknath, majjanmana phalamidam, I have taken birth in this material world. I think it is the net achievement of my human birth. majjanma na phalamidam. Madhukoito bhare. Madhukoito bhare mean? He is speaking to na, Prabhu, Supreme Lord. Madhukoito bhare. Madhu namak daitya. He killed. Madhukoito. Daitya. Demons killed. That's why. Madhukoito bhare. It is my prayer unto your lotus feet. Matparthaniya madanugrahevasa. It is my only prayer unto your lotus feet, and I can think, I can treat that it is your actual kripa. If you can give me this kind of feeling, that I like to become servant of the servant of the servant of the servant of a servant, you know, of your servant. Tadvritto bhitto paricharako. Vritto, vritto, vrittosva vritto, iti mangs marulokanat. If you want to give me, if you want to give me some identity, this kind of identity I like. It is your kipa. I can think that it is your kipa because you are going to give me direct feeling that I, so that I can become a servant of the 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 servant, your sevak. This is my ultimate goal of life. And Kulasekar also, Srila Bhaktivedanta Bharati Maharaj also used to speak this, you know, this thing. How Kulasekar was devotee. Kulasekar was devotee actually. But ultimately Kulasekar wanted to leave the kingdom. Kulasekar was just fed up with those, you know, surrounding people. Those were cheaters. All minister, you know, all, you know, wife, all cheater, they are all cheater. So Kulasekar gradually developed so strong detachment, Kulasekar took decision to leave this kingdom and go away exclusively, to do bhajan exclusively. How? Actually, there was a big temple in his, you know, palace. Before entering palace, you can find a big temple of Narayan. Because South Indian people, they used to worship Narayan. Narayan, actually, Supreme Lord. So, there was a big temple, and they are worshipping everything, all going on with full, you know, appliances there also in the temple. Always serving, you know, those who are sadhu, sannyasis, taking place. Oh, every time, going and coming. All the time, seva going on, and there was big ornament and jewels, everything for Prabhu, Supreme Lord. But someday, very, very costly, you know, ornaments and, you know, these jewels are stolen. All stolen. How stolen? Nobody can see. How stolen? King cannot catch anybody. But king can realize that it must be a plotting of, you know, those who are staying with me, any one of them must have done their criminal. But how to detect? Because I cannot, without any direct document, I cannot give punishment to anybody. So he took decision that how to give punishment. I cannot give punishment to anybody, and I will have to detect who is the main culprit. Then the king took decision to arrange one testing. To arrange one testing. Because he is praying in front of the Supreme Lord, O Prabhu, I like to give punishment to the man who has done this, you know, great offense. So he is going to arrange one thing, one big aquarium. Aquarium. Aquarium means actually not aquarium means we mean that there is water, there is fish. It's like structure like aquarium. There is all around glasses there, glass covering, and up also there is glass covering, but there is one hole through which you can put your hand inside. There is one hole through which you can put your hand inside that box, glass box. It's not aquarium, glass box. And a king actually going to put some poisonous snacks. King Kulosika going to put some poisonous snacks inside that box, glass box. And there is one hole. And king going to invite everybody, whole, you know, those who are staying in, you know, all around. That everybody will have to put hand inside this box. Nobody ready? Well, no. You will have to put hand inside this box. If you are not actually criminal, if you are not, you know, then if you are not culprit, then snake not going to bite you. And praying in front of Supreme Lord out of love, O Prabhu, you are there inside the heart of everybody. As Paramatma, inside the heart of that snake also. So it is my request unto your lotus feet, Prabhu. Those who are innocent, you know, their snake should not cut. You know, with this, you know, prayer, the king arranged one big, you know, sabha, assembly, in which king speaking, first of all, I am going to put my hand inside this box. Inside this box. Yeah, look. Then king going to put hand, and before that is begin. Oh, snake, be careful. If anybody innocent, you should not bite. Then is first of all that king going to put hand inside that box. Then snake not biting. Then after that is arranging everyone one by one. And the main, you know, Pradhan Mantri, who is the main, you know, Prime Minister, requesting. But the Prime Minister not ready to put hand. Why? He started crying. Then he was arrested. After that it was found, he confessed that I am the guilty. This way actually, after that, that King Kulosekar developed this kind of detachment, whom I rely, they are actually all cheater, this queen, this minister, these all. So why should I stay here? I should leave this place. This way, they are going to leave this place forever and going to do bhajan exclusively. This way actually, so those who are in a material bonded soul, they never going to develop that kind of detachment, because they are going to expect some enjoyment still today. They are going to expect some enjoyment. That's why they are not going to, you know, leave material enjoyment. They cannot get bhakti. This is the main thing. But Prabhupada always used to guide them in such a way so that they cannot develop that kind of enjoying mood. But still, after Prabhupada gone from this material world, there are so many problems. I don't like to touch these points, actually. So many things happen after Prabhupada gone. And Prabhupada, in his letter, speaking in front of, you know, some devotees, that I am not agree with you, because you think you have some speciality. You think Prabhupada writing in one letter to one devotee, disciple, so-called disciple, that you always think that you have some, Prabhupada speaking, that you always try to follow your own way. You always try to follow your own way. Pradipat Panibeshna Seva. These are the three procedures through which you can develop Saranagati, you can get all Bhakti, Tattagyan, everything. But you are not ready to follow this three texts. Paripat, Paribhasna, Seva. These three texts. You are going to live these three texts. You are going to follow your whimsical mind. What benefit I can do for you? What I can do for you? I have nothing to do. You are going to give argument that in your life you already accepted some, you know, some sannyasis, some brahmacharis, and some exalted personalities. You thought they are really exalted. there, you know, exalted personalities. After that, you discovered some faults in them. After that, you are going to lose your mentality to do bhajan. Prabhupada speaking, this kind of, you know, this kind of, you know, mood of suicide, I cannot approve. Maybe somebody going to develop, maybe somebody going to fall down, but what is concern to you? You should not, you know, be so weak to flow away in Maya. Miche Mayar vase jachya veshe khachya habudubu bhai. We should not float in Maya. You can say they are doing this, so I cannot check myself. But Prabhupada speaking, I cannot, I am not going to agree with you. Because if you like to get that absolute truth, if you are really interested, if you are really interested to get that absolute truth, then nobody can put problem in front of you. You have some weakness, you are going to follow them, you are going to follow them as your master, you are not going to follow me. So this way, now you are bound to go away from. So it is my request, don't, Prabhupada speaking, it is my request, don't try to find fault with others, try to find fault with yourself. Don't try to follow the mood of Ekalabhya. Prabhupada speaking, don't try to follow the mood of Ekalabhya. Rather, you should follow the mood of that Patibrata Chesti Ramani. Patibrata Ramani. You should follow the mood of Patibrata Ramani. That, you know, Patibrata Ramani. You should follow the mood of Patibrata Ramani. See, you should not follow the mood of Ekalabhya. Ekalabhya, Ekalabhya going to prove that he is, you know, he is, Ekalabhya want to prove that he is getting power from Gurudev. But actually Ekalabhya getting some power. Concentration of mind is doing, but it is not actually bhakti. Because Gurudev never approved Ekalabhya. Gurudev never approved him. So he is forcefully going to do this thing. So this is not actually bhakti. So Prabhupada speaking, we should not follow this mood of Ekalabhya. Rather, we should follow the mood of Pratibhata Ramani. Prabhupada speaking, je Pratibhata Ramani Patilagi Koilo Veshashyavan. Pratibhata Ramani, what being? Because to satisfy husband is going to follow, some, you know, procedure through which she can satisfy husband. So to satisfy Supreme Lord, I mean Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we must follow our Gurudev, Guru Vaishnava in this, you know, Srauta Pantha. We are not going to follow. We are not going to follow the idealism of a, you know, material personality. Maybe he is big, have some position and honor in this material world, but we are not. So, in the idealism of Prabhupada, we never find this kind of suicidal attitude, atmahatya, that he is doing wrong, so I can also do wrong. I can also do wrong. Many times before I told, actually, when Prabhupada, you know, organizing a big, you know, society, there can be some problem. So sometime Srila Gosai Maharaj and Srila Hayagriva Brahmachari, Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Gosai Maharaj and Aprakita Prabhu, they are approaching Prabhupada and speaking, Prabhupada, we are collecting money here and money, you know, seva from different places, but we are not ready to hand over this seva to this in charge. We like to hand over to you because they are not going to use it properly. But Prabhupada said, do you think I don't know? Do you think that I don't know? I know nothing about that. I know. But what it concern to you? What it concern to you? Someday they approach Prabhupada and speaking, we like to leave this society, we cannot stay. Prabhupada say, why? Because this is the proceed, this is the you know thing, corruption going on. Prabhupada speaking, what it concern to you? Do you think I don't know? They are coming to me not for Hari Bhajan. They are coming to me to get some material facility. They are coming to me to get some material facility. So they are getting this. But you are coming to me to get bhakti. What is the problem with you? I am with you. You do go on doing bhajan. This way Prabhupada always gives to give, you know, support to them, those who are actually interested to do bhajan. Those who are actually interested to follow Prabhupada, for them Prabhupada was very, all the time Prabhupada speaking, je, never try to criticize others. Always try to find fault with yourself. Then you can rectify. I have my responsibility, I am acting as Acharya. So it is my responsibility to speak heavily. So why you are going to take trouble? Why you are going to take trouble in this matter? Why you are going to get control over Guru Vaishnava? It is my duty. I am acting as Acharya, so I'll have to do. So why you are going to, you know, take that kind of responsibility? You should not, you know. So this way, Prabhupada always used to check the mentality of, you know, getting control over others. Shiksha Guru, Diksha Guru, or, you know, Prabhupada used to say, there should not be any material conception. Na marto buddhya suyeto sarvadeva mayo guru. So all the time, you should think, Gurudev is not material man. Gurudev is not material personality. So Gurudev is Supreme Lord Himself. So, na marto buddha asuyeto sarvadeva mayo guru. With material conception, if you are going to, you know, give treatment with Gurudev, then big problem, you can fall down. So how to, Prabhupada used to speak, that how we can, you know, tasmad guru prapadyeta jigyasu seyottama, jigyasu seyottam, sabde parichanisnatam, brahmani upasamasrayam. Without Vaikuntha realization, without direct realization, one cannot preach. If there is no direct realization, Vaikuntha Bhav realization, he cannot act as a Aprakita Guru. The symptom of a Aprakita Guru, Prabhupada always used to speak, that the symptom of a Aprakita Guru is his non-stop seva mood. When you can find, he is busy with continuous non-stop seva mood, he is busy with seva, Vaikuntha Bhav always, Vaikuntha Bhav, always and every time having some exceptional personality, having some, you know, induction in Saiha. All the time Vaikuntha Bhav, he can act as Acharya, he can go for preaching. Ordinary men cannot go for preaching, it's not possible for them. So, in Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, Prabhupada speaking, how to get tattva jnana? It is written that tatro bhagavatana dharmana sikshet guruvatma devataha amayaya anubritva jvaistu shet atma atmado harihi. Tatro bhagavatana dharmana. Bhagavad dharma. Bhagavad Dharma Tattva Gyan, how to get? How to get Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan? Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, this is the procedure written in Bhagavatam. तत्रो भागवतानु धर्मानु शिक्षेत गुरुवात्म दैवतः यू कैन गेट फुल नॉलेज अबाउट धर्म फ्रॉम योर गुरुदेव एंड यू शुड थिंक गुरुदेव एंड भगवान नॉन डिफरेंट इच अदर तत्रो भागवतानु धर्मानु शिक्षेत गुरुवात्म दैवतः एंड अमायाया अनुवृत्वा अमायावनुभूत 100% इंक्लिनेशन देर शुड नॉट बी डिप्लिसिटी अमायाय देर शुड नॉट बी एनी गैपिंग ऑफ माया योर अनुगत्य इज देयर बट सम गैपिंग ऑफ माया इज देयर सो इट इज नॉट एक्चुअल अनुगत्य सो तत्रो भगवतान धर्मान शिक्षित गुरुवात्म दैवतः अमायाया अनुवृत्वा जयस्तुष्येत आत्मा आत्मदो हरि अमाया अनुवृत्ता मीन माने यू विल हैव टू फॉलो योर सदगुरु हिज हार्ट टोटली टोटो देर शुड नॉट बी एनी डिस्पेरिटी अमाया अनुवृत्त अमाया विदाउट एनी माया आई मीन फुल सिंसियरिटी यू हैव टू ओबे कैरी आउट द ऑर्डर ऑफ गुरु वैष्णव आई मीन सेवा अमाया अनुवृत्ता अनुवृत्ता मीन नॉन स्टॉप सेवा अनुवृत्ता मीन अनुगत्व बाय इन परसेप्चुअल चैनल सौतपंथ एस पर अमाया अनुवृत्ता एंड इफ यू कैन डू दिस वे इन दैट केस यू कैन गेट भगवत तत्व विज्ञान मुक्त संगस्व पर्यायते जयस्तु से आत्मा आत्मदो हरि एंड थ्रू दिस प्रोसीड्योर सुप्रीम लॉर्ड कैन बिकम वेरी हैप्पी Through this procedure, Supreme Lord can become very happy. And not only there, but also Supreme Lord like to sell himself in front of that devotee. Jais tushyed atma atmado harihi. Supreme Lord can sell himself. You can remember in Bhagavad Gita, one sloka is there. Aham bhakta paradhina hi asatantra yuvadijo, this sloka. The Bhagavan like to be controlled by that devotee who is going to follow Sadguru, not Asadguru. Most of us think that Prabhupada in his, you know, Leela, so many people, you know, why I speak this thing actually, so many devotees of Prabhupada, they used to find fault with Prabhupada. They're thinking that Prabhupada speaking Harikatha, but Prabhupada speaking, doing this way, so there must be some fault with Prabhupada. This way, you know, sometime they used to think that if Prabhupada is antarjami, if at all Prabhupada is excellent acharya, then why Prabhupada going to approve their activities? If Prabhupada at all antarjami, Prabhupada is actually excellent acharya, then why Prabhupada going to approve them, their activities, their material activities, this kind of, but they cannot understand the mood of Srila Prabhupada. Many times I told, before that Prabhupada used to speak, that I can come down to any level for the actual seva of Chaitanya Vani. For Gauranga seva, I can do anything externally. Externally you can find, but internally Prabhupada not going to approve anybody. Somebody going to fight with Prabhupada. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone in the year of, you know, 1914, after some, you know, days, they are fighting with Prabhupada, speaking, you are so heavy. Actually at the time of Prabhupada, at the time of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to call kirtan party. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to call kirtan party from, you know, Santipur. We have seen they used to do kirtan. So many people used to come, but you never approve. Prabhupada speaking, actually, you can never understand the mood of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You can never understand the mood of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was never in favor of that kind of sahaja kirtan. But we have seen The Pope was speaking. Now Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, just gone, you are going to fight with me. After some day you can, you know, you can find so many faults with her. Be sure that Bhaktivinoda Thakur was not Sahaja. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was accurately Shuddha Bhakti. Sometime Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to arrange this kind of function to cheat you. Those are foolish people. You know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to arrange this kind of function. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to sit there and doing Harinam. Why? Because those who are less interested to cook, less interested to come to Dham, those who are less interested to do Sadhu Sangha, those who are not going to hear Harikatha, for them Bhaktivinoda Thakur was very clever. He used to arrange one Sahaja Kirtan so that naturally so many people can come. After that, they can have the chance to look at the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They can hear Harikatha from big sadhus. They can get benefit. You can go through the Bani, writings of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Never. So Prabhupada speaking, if we think this way, that Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to arrange, you know, Sahaja Kirtan, it is totally wrong Siddhanta. Never Bhaktivinoda Thakur arranged this kind of Kirtan. But it is one kind of technique. It is one kind of technique, but at present we cannot, you know, follow this kind of technique. But this kind of gigantic spiritual figure like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he can do it. We cannot do it. You know, we cannot do it. Bhaktivinoda used to call in Jagabit Simandir, Ganesh Kirtaniya for Santipur, this, that, doing Kirtan party, everything. Prabhupada speaking, we have no right to hear this kind of Kirtan, Sahaja Kirtan, you know, in market. We have no right to hear this kind of Sahaja Kirtan in market, open market. We have no right. They have no sense control over their sense organ, nothing. We cannot allow. Bhaktivinoda Thakur never allow this kind of. But you think so, what to do? So, you know what to do. This way actually, Prabhupada speaking, that actually at the time of Prabhupada, so many devotees, they always used to misunderstand Prabhupada, his activities. But they always used to misunderstand Prabhupada, and ultimately they gone away living. So they used to express doubt why Prabhupada going to arrange, you know, this kind of arrangement Prabhupada doing. Anderson Sahib when coming, why Prabhupada doing this? Maybe Prabhupada is not Siddha Mahatma, maybe Prabhupada is not, you know, Antaryami. They can think. So this way always Prabhupada, you know, Prabhupada used to follow such a procedure so that maximum preaching can be done. Maximum, you know, Harikatha Kirtan all the time. But those who are not going to follow the instruction of Prabhupada, is a Siddhanta Vichara of Prabhupada, if they are going to look what Prabhupada doing, then they are going to make mistake. They cannot understand. To realize a great sadhu like Prabhupada, we'll have to follow his Siddhanta Vichara. Because when they are speaking Siddhanta Vichara, they are not going to cheat us. Like in their deceptive attitude, sometimes they are expressing, you know, this kind of mood. So in that case, there is every possibility that we can misunderstand him. So, as and when necessary, Prabhupada used to follow this kind of, used to do this kind of lila, but common people, they have no right to understand this point. So, this way, we always want to prove that we have taken initiation from Prabhupada, that is all. We got the chance to stay with Prabhupada for a long time, so he dissolved. But actually, they never can understand the mood of Prabhupada. They can never. They stayed there with Prabhupada, but they couldn't realize the mood of Srila Prabhupada all the time. So, this way actually, we are always deviated from the track of Srila Prabhupada. This way we are always deviated from the track of Srila Prabhupada. In the life of any Sadguru Acharya, we can find two things very important. Anugraha and Nigraha. Anytime they can give kippa and they can give punishment also. Sadguru Vaishnava, they have right to give me punishment. At the same time, they can give me punishment and they can give kippa also. So, if we misunderstand him, if we cannot understand this kind of mood of Guru Vishnu, they have right to give me punishment, at the same time they have right to give kippa. If we misunderstand, then big problem. We can fall down. If we like to criticize him, why? You know. So I like to stop today with this. Actually, kipaya hori kirtana murti dharam dharani varaharak gaura janam janakadika vasala snigda padam panamami sada prabhupadu padam panamami sada prabhupadu padam panamami sada prabhupadu padam vanchakalpadurvasi kipasindu babesha patitanam pavana babeshna bhyo namo.